Hello everyone and welcome to TechVec++. In today's video, we will be covering an old school hardware, that is Intel Pentium III processor. We will discuss its specification, its design and what's inside the processor. So let's get started. Intel Pentium III was released back in 2000. The die size or lithography of this processor was 180 nanometer, which consisted of 21 million transistors. It was a single core processor. Its clock speeds were from 600 MHz to 1 GHz. Sockets on which Pentium III was set up were PPGA 370, SECC2 and SECC2495. It had a cache of 256 kilobytes, runs on a total of 29 watt TDP and designed on 32 bit instruction set. Let's look what is inside this processor. As you can see, I have disassembled the processor and it teared up in four parts. First one is a shroud with a small fan on it. Second is the heat sink to dissipate heat. Third one is the PCB for the processor chip on which CPU lies. And lastly, the fourth part is its backplate. Coming to the processor, in the center you can see this blue shade silicon wafer, and inside it lies all the 21 million transistors. This is actually your processor, which does all your calculations. Connector design to attach this CPU is very different from modern processors. It uses a connection type which is similar to a game cassette from Sega or Atari back in 2000s. It is also similar to the connections we use in PCIe hardwares. Focusing on the main processor chip, you can see connection lines going inside the silicon wafer. Flipping back the processor shows that all the connection lines coming from the motherboard is connecting to the processor chip, and from there they are connecting to the silicon chip. Moreover, you can see multiple capacitors and resistors throughout the PCB. In today's processors, all these conditions to set up the processor is already being done on the motherboard. Thus, it reduces the size of the modern processors. Intel Pentium III was the last processor to follow this type of design. After that, Intel Pentium IV introduced the design which is currently being used on the modern processors. Hope you guys liked the video. Press like and leave a comment, and don't forget to subscribe for upcoming amazing content.